I represent BTC Arabic, which is an organization that has been in business for the last 70 something years. For 60 of those years, it's been purely a radio station and purely a radio operation. In 1998, it was we launched the Arabic website. Initially, purely as an advertising front for the radio, and then as a news site on its own. Since 1998, the most visible development of this this website has been how it has increasingly relied on user participation and lately on user-generated content as well. Earlier this year, we launched our Arabic language television station, and now we are using our website to, as a vehicle to convey radio, television, as well as online content. This is a diagram which can give you a rough guide to what we offer at the moment. I mean, we're using many different platforms to convey, to transmit our radio, television, and our online content to users. It's you can access our products now on mobile devices, on through RSS, through breaking news tools, through embedded video, and then through sharing by social networking, and many other platforms. This is gives you an idea about how we started and where we are now. You see, in 1998, we were purely a text-based website, which was written in Word, actually, in the beginning, if you can believe that. Then it progressed mainly through, or mainly to increase user participation. For example, we have what we call our Talking Point program, which is currently running three times a week, live on television and on radio, simultaneously on online. Through this program, users can participate either through text messages, through phoning, through sending videos, and it all enhances the user experience. Another point is the talking point on any other subject that that a user can have any comments about. But I have to make a proviso here that our talking points are moderated. They're not like certain other organizations. Embedded video is another new development which entered into service about a year ago. Videos are embedded into stories, and these videos can then be shared either through social networks or email to friends and acquaintances. We also have online TV and radio, which users can access our broadcasts, TV and radio broadcasts live on our website, and also latest news bulletins on demand. RSS feeds, of course, are also provided for our news pages. We also plan to have all our stories linked to social social websites like, Facebook and Reddit. We also have our breaking news tool, which users can download and put on their desktop for breaking news to come on. Breaking news can also be accessed through RSS through SMS messages on mobile devices. News on mobile devices can be, users can register to have them either as SMS messages or as to download a Java application which can open a web page with the news on, with our news page on. We are also planning, although it's now operational in certain markets, we're planning to go for TV on 3G mobiles in all markets as well. user-generated content. We're making much more use of user-generated content at the moment, whether it's as videos or as photographs. These can be used to enhance the coverage of certain important events, like, for example, obviously the latest events in Gaza. News and blogs. We don't have any permanent blogs yet, but what we do is that when certain important events come along, our correspondents open diary pages, which are semi-blogs. We might go into the blog permanent blog route in the future. We also have a forum for people to connect with our service to discuss any issues that they might have. This is the a broad outline of what we are offering at the moment. The main thrust of our progress now and of what we anticipate our progress to be in the future is more user participation, because this we believe is the way to the future as far as we are concerned. And thank you very much.